Thank you for your introduction. As shown here, the title of my presentation is Simple Method of Automatic Risks Assessment for Web Systems, Considering Asset Sensitivity. To begin with, let me tell you something about myself. My name is Mitsuharu Sasaki, and I'm a member of NTT CERT, which is a CERT organization of NTT, a Japanese telecommunications company. Up to now, I have been engaged in vulnerability assessment and management for 7 years. And in my present research, my goal is to achieve security operations that anyone can easily perform. Okay, let me begin by giving you an overview of our research. Our objective is to automate the work of risks assessment that up to now has been done manually. This work has required advanced skills and has been costly to perform. To meet this objective, we propose a simple risks assessment considering the asset sensitivity of web systems. This method automatically calculates the asset sensitivity of a web system from access logs and web content, and output a risk score without requiring advanced skills. It calculates asset sensitivity from the viewpoint of confidentiality, integrity, and availability, and combines this asset sensitivity with CVSS to output a risk score. We perform risk assessment considering asset sensitivity and examine the effectiveness of the proposal method by an experiment using web systems operated in an actual company. My presentation is organized as shown here. Background, proposal method, evaluation experiment, result and discussion, and conclusion. Okay, let me give you some background. According to the National Vulnerability Database, the number of vulnerability is increasing year by year. A total of 80,356 vulnerabilities were reported in 2020. In particular, anyone can access web systems that are open to the public on the internet, so there are many opportunities for attacks. Appropriate countermeasures to vulnerabilities must be taken. However, this huge number of publicly released vulnerabilities makes it difficult to deal with all of them. For this reason, many corporate security analysts and administrators need to quickly assess risks to prioritize vulnerability countermeasures. In general, risk can be determined from three elements: asset, vulnerability, and threat. Risk can be determined by assessing each target system from the viewpoint of what kind of system has what kind of vulnerability and what kind of threat exists. However, assessing the risk of each system is difficult for these three reasons. First, there are many systems managed by security analysts and administrators, so risk assessment takes time. Second, while a variety of guidelines for risk assessment are presented by NIST, ISO, and other organizations, they tend to be highly versatile but highly abstract at the same time. This means that analysts themselves must decide on detailed procedures, and they must possess advanced skills such as knowledge of business operations and knowledge of risks assessment. Third, today's shortage of security experts is making it extremely difficult to educate and secure personnel having such a specialized skills. As a result, risk assessment is not an easy task due to a variety of cost factors, including operational cost and cost of acquiring skilled personnel. Practically speaking, we can assess risks and prioritize vulnerability countermeasures by using a vulnerability assessment method called the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a framework for assessing vulnerabilities. It expresses the severity of a particular vulnerability by a 10-level CVSS score. We can assess risks easily by using CVSS scores. However, in general, published CVSS-based scores do not consider assets. They are values that focus only on vulnerability and threat, which means that they cannot provide an appropriate assessment of the target system. There is a concern that countermeasures to higher risk vulnerabilities will be put off until later, and that more money than necessary will be spent on security countermeasures. Therefore, there is a need to establish an automatic risk assessment method considering asset sensitivity. Up to now, a variety of risk assessment methods have been proposed, but most of previous research has focused on vulnerabilities and threat. A few risk assessment methods that consider asset sensitivity have been proposed. For example, Ax et al., they propose a method that defines asset sensitivity as the sum of the CVSS scores of the vulnerabilities possessed by the system. However, this is a method focused on vulnerabilities. It does not sufficiently consider asset. In addition, Shakibazat et al. Proposed a method for determining asset sensitivity using system information like server function. However, in this method, analysts must manually collect and classify asset information, which requires advanced skills. In response to these problems, we propose a risk assessment method that automatically considers asset sensitivity in a web system. Here is a conceptual diagram of the proposed method. This method consists of three processes. The first process is data collection. This process obtains web content from the target web system. The second process is calculation of asset sensitivity. This process calculates asset sensitivity by analyzing the web content and previously prepared access logs. The third process is output of risk score. This process outputs a risk score by evaluating the given CVSS score based on CVSS environmental metrics using asset sensitivity. The proposed method assumed websites that have web content as target systems. It also considers administrators and security analysts that must manage many websites. In addition, the asset sensitivity values and risk scores calculated by the proposed method are not absolute values. They are expressed as a relative ranking among the web systems in the organization. In the following slide, I will describe in detail each process of proposed method. In data collection process, input is the FQDN of a target system. This FQDN is used to collect the web content of the target system using a web crawler. The correction process begins by searching for any links within the top page. It makes transition to each page pointed to by link and get the content of that page. Then it searches for links again within each of those pages. This process is repeated up to a specified hierarchy to correct web content. Next, I will describe the calculation of asset sensitivity. In the proposed method, we focused on the viewpoint of confidentiality, integrity, and availability. The first index is sensitivity of confidentiality, denoted by alpha. We consider that the more confidential information a system has, the greater the impact. The second index is sensitivity of integrity, denoted by beta. The more web content and function a system has, the greater the impact. Finally, the third index is sensitivity of availability, denoted by gamma. The greater the number of system users, the greater the impact. The three terms alpha, beta, and gamma corresponding to these three elements are now summed up to give asset sensitivity S. In the following slides, I will describe in detail each of three elements. First is sensitivity of confidentiality, alpha. This sensitivity is calculated based on whether a login form exists and the number of accesses. We chose the existence of a login form as a basis for this calculation because a system having confidential information should restrict access by authentication functions. In addition, we chose number of accesses as another basis for this calculation. Since the volume of confidential information tends to increase proportionally to the number of users, which means that the impact of an incident is likely to be great for a large number of users. Here, A of W sub I denotes the number of accesses to the target system W sub I, and L of W sub I denotes whether a login form exists in the context of the target system. The number of accesses is determined by counting the number of unique IP addresses from access logs. The process calculates the product A and L for each system and uses the maximum value of these products as a logarithmic base. Then it calculates the logarithm of the target system to determine the value alpha. Next is sensitivity of integrity beta. This sensitivity is calculated by determining the total number of content items and parameters in each page. This is based on the idea that since tampering occurs by the misuse of functions on the system, the greater the number of content items and functions that can be tampered with, the greater the impact when an incident occurs. Here, B of W sub I denotes the number of content items in target system W sub I. It is calculated from the number of pages in the obtained content. In addition, C of W sub I denotes the number of parameters in target system W sub I. It is calculated by counting the parameters used by the system from input tags and form tags within a page. Similar to confidentiality calculations, the process calculates B of W sub I and C of W sub I for each target system and uses the maximum value of B of W sub I and of C of W sub I as a logarithmic basis. It calculates the logarithm of B of W sub I and of C of W sub I and sums the two logarithms to determine the value beta. Finally, we calculate sensitivity of availability gamma. This sensitivity is calculated from number of accesses. This is based on the idea that the greater the number of users, the greater the impact when a system outage occurs. Here, the number of accesses is calculated from access logs obtained from the target system. As in the previous calculations, the maximum value of A of W sub calculated for each target system is used as a logarithmic base. And the logarithm of A of W sub I for the target system is calculated to give the value gamma. Next, I'll describe the process for outputting a risk score. This process calculates risk using the environmental metrics of CVSS. These environmental metrics are defined by CVSS. They serve as metrics for assessing the vulnerability risk, including the asset of the target system. Risk is expressed by this formula. Here, impact is a term related to asset, and exploitability is a term related to the vulnerability and threat. The impact term includes the variables called security requirements, which based on the conditions of the target system. When the vulnerability is published, the values of terms other than these security requirements are simultaneously published. So consequently, in the proposed method, we only replace the values of these security requirements with asset sensitivity values and evaluate the CVSS score to determine the risk score. The term CR, IR, and AR respectively related to confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Each is expressed by the term corresponding to its asset sensitivity plus K. Here, K is a constant equal to 0.5, which is used to match each of those terms with the CVSS score range. I will now describe the evaluation experiment. For this evaluation, we used web systems operated by an actual company and performed an evaluation using rank correlation coefficient between system importance and asset sensitivity. Here, system importance expresses a level decided beforehand by a security analyst in the company based on internal company policies. A system deemed important by the company is set to high, and a system not deemed important is set to low. The types of systems used in this experiment include the company's official website, customer service site, tech blog, product introduction site, and so on. This experiment evaluates whether a correlation exists between previously assigned system importance and asset sensitivity obtained by the proposed method. In the experiment, we evaluated a total of 18 systems collected access logs for a period of 1 month, starting from July 1st, 2020, and collected data by searching through three hierarchical layers. To begin with, here, the result of calculating asset sensitivity for each of the 18 systems. For this category, based on system importance, it has not been possible to evaluate the difference in asset sensitivities between systems within the same category, that is high or low. However, it can be seen here that the quantitative values provided by the proposed method make it possible to rank each system. This slide showed the result of calculating asset sensitivity in detail. First, sensitivity of confidentiality alpha tended to have high scores for main website that handle customer information such as customer service site. Next, sensitivity of integrity beta tended to have high scores for large websites such as the company's official website. And finally, sensitivity of availability gamma tended to have high scores for websites with a large number of users. Next, this slide shows the rank correlation coefficient and the distribution of asset sensitivity. Using Spearman's rank correlation coefficient, we determine the correlation coefficient between system importance and asset sensitivity. We obtained a positive correlation of 0.82 for asset sensitivity S, which suggests that the proposal method is a valid indicator of system importance. Also, a positive correlation was obtained for the elements alpha, beta, and gamma. The right figure shows a normalized histogram of asset sensitivity. These results show that systems of high importance can be separated from systems of low importance according to asset sensitivity, which indicates that company policies can be expressed by our asset sensitivity. Finally, as a case study, we present an example of outputting the risk score using actual vulnerabilities. Here, we present only a portion of these results concerning space limitations. We calculate risk scores using two vulnerabilities related to web servers. The first vulnerability relates to the Apache HTTP server. It affects confidentiality and integrity. CVSS basis score is 6.1. The second vulnerability relates to the Microsoft IIS server. It affects only availability. CVSS basis score is 7.5. We calculate the risk score considering the asset sensitivity of the target system using computation formula for CVSS environmental metrics. On examining these results, we can see that system 3, having the highest asset sensitivity, obtained the highest risk score for these vulnerabilities. Furthermore, on comparing system 5 and system 6 with respect to the CVE 2019-941, system 5 has higher, but the risk score, the system 6, is a higher, get higher risk score. This suggests the feasibility of risk assessment concerning the asset sensitivity of each score. Because the gamma of system 6 is higher than system 5, and so this vulnerability affected only availability. So this result reflects a correct evaluation. So in the past, it is difficult to prioritize vulnerability countermeasures based on CVSS based scores without considering asset sensitivity. However, using the proposed method to evaluate risk scores would make it possible. For example, if the budget for vulnerability countermeasures is limited, countermeasures for system 3 should be given priority. Based on these results, we can say that the proposed method worked as hypothesized for the most part, and that is proved to be an effective technique. However, we found that some issues remained. First, it is difficult to calculate asset sensitivity in the system that has no login pages, but that collects and manages customer information through a contact page. Second, it is difficult to crawl through pages that make a transition by inputting appropriate parameters through web forms or APIs, which makes it difficult to calculate accurate scores. We need to make further improvement to deal with these issues. I will now conclude my presentation. We propose a simple method of risk assessment considering asset sensitivity. This method defines asset sensitivity and automatically outputs a risk score using access logs and web content. In this way, it is a method that can assess risk without requiring advanced skills. We confirm the effectiveness of the proposal method by conducting an evaluation experiment using web systems of an actual company. That completes my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.